Ladies and gentlemen, here is the early morning news of the world, and before we start our roundup of world capitals, here in the New York newsroom, we have the latest reports on fighting in the Pacific theater. The first round of the battle for the Dutch East Indies may not be over yet, but so far the Allied nations are way ahead. Upwards of 30 Japanese ships so far have been sunk or damaged in the great running sea and air fight in Makassar Strait between Borneo and Celebes. American and Dutch forces between them are believed to have accounted for close to 25,000 Japanese soldiers gone down with their transport ships. The latest success is the torpedoing of a Japanese aircraft carrier announced by the Navy Department last night. The big ship is believed to have sunk after the attack by an American submarine. The Australian Air Force, employing the same tactics as the Americans and the Dutch, struck at the Japanese invasion fleet in the Bismarck Islands during the night, and a Melbourne communique says that three Jap ships were damaged in Rabaul Harbor. Now, Tokyo today claims the Japanese troops in Malaya are within 30 miles of Singapore, but there is no British confirmation for that. Remember, that's a Tokyo claim. Now, there's no indication yet of where the British line is now that Batu Pahat has been lost, but on the west, at least, the front is less than 60 miles from Singapore. In Burma, according to a Rangoon communique, there's no change in the situation. And it isn't quite clear from that whether General Headquarters at Rangoon means that British troops still are withdrawing toward Mulmain or whether they've braced their lines. The American volunteer flyers in Burma have smashed another Japanese attempt to attack Rangoon from the air. In the latest clash, they shot down three and maybe four Japanese planes. The exact toll of Japanese losses in the Battle of Makassar is most difficult to compute because communiques from various sources overlap. But Washington has announced that American naval forces have accounted for at least 8 and possibly 10 Japanese transports. American Flying Fortress bombers sank another transport and set fire to one. And then there's the aircraft carrier, which makes at least 13 ships sunk, or probably sunk, by American forces. Now, the Dutch have blasted as many or more. Now, here's a late bulletin from Batavia. The Japanese are believed to have extended their landings in southwest Celebes. The Netherlands High Command says the invaders apparently have occupied their points in the Kendari region of that island. In the southern hemisphere, the Pan-American Conference at Rio de Janeiro closes today, with every indication of being the most important in the history of inter-hemispheric relations. A final plenary session is scheduled to give formal approval to 39 resolutions designed to cleanse the entire hemisphere of Axis influences. Adoption of the resolutions is regarded as, well, just only a formality. But one century-old problem still threatens to sound a discordant note at the otherwise harmonious finale. It's the border dispute between Ecuador and Peru. Now, Ecuador may bring up the argument at the conference today unless Peru previously accepts a formula for settling the controversy. In Montevideo, an authoritative source discloses that Uruguay's diplomatic delegations in Berlin and in Rome have closed their offices. Now, the staffs will leave soon for Lisbon, preparatory to sailing for home. Uruguay is one of the 17 American nations that have broken diplomatic relations with the Axis. The diplomatic break, in addition to an economic break, has been recommended by the country.